And welcome back. Thanks for doing those sandbox interviews.
Yeah, my pleasure.
It was a lot of fun to see exactly what the developers are seeing, especially with Google Plus, since it is a fairly new platform in terms of Google. I want to ask you real quick, what did the developers say to you that really struck you? You know, what was it about their initial interaction with Google Plus and Google Plus sign-in that they're finding, and how are their users responding?
You know, universally, first of all, they said that their experience with the Google Plus team on the development side was fantastic, that they were there with them every step of the way, you know, understanding new ways that they could kind of iterate on Google Plus. And as you say, it is a relatively new way for developers to think about including it in any site, whether it's the sign-in or Hangouts or whatever it is. And they were really kind of pushing what was possible and thinking of new ways to do it, which I thought was really cool. And they were extremely complimentary of the Google Plus team.
And one thing I think that's really been highlighted, not only in our discussion of Google I.O., what we're focused on at this entire conference, but even the press response has been absolutely solid this year, is seeing how closely we're focused on the developer community.
Yeah.
You know, obviously we have a lot of really interesting services that impact consumers, but this is all about developers at this conference.
Yeah, almost every story that I've read about this has referenced that in some way, that it is a huge acknowledgement to that developer community that yes, of course there are things here that consumers are interested in. However, the bulk of the announcements and the conversations here are really targeted at developers.
Now, as someone who works in developer relations and runs Google Developers Live, that's like music to my ears.
Yep.
And so I'm really excited to see that the developers are hearing what we've been saying and making their applications better for users with the APIs and the tools that we've given them. And one thing I wanted to look at, when you look at yesterday's keynote, we had a really interesting update to Google Play. And not only did Google Play get a refresh, and like we said, it looks the same across mobile and tablet and desktop.
From a design standpoint.
Yeah,
UI.
But one of the things that was especially important was really what Google takes to the heart of everything we do is data. And making sure that they have the analytics of that data. And so you look about a Google Plus sign-in user, and you look at really any Android application development user, you basically have a situation where you can count exactly how many installs you have, whether that's going up or down, and to improve the type of analytics to help you do a better job of marketing your devices, marketing your applications, and seeing what's working and what's not.
Yeah.
I thought it was especially important to take the learnings that we have from Google Analytics, where we can really tell you what's happening on your website in real time and tell you ways to improve your campaigns from a marketing perspective. But to do that on Google Play just makes sense.
Yeah, to be able to do that rapidly and strategically and get that feedback through Google Analytics, I mean, I think that was something that a lot of these developers were craving for a long time, frankly, and now that they have that ability, you know, as you say, to kind of make those changes and change, you know, very quickly, I think that's very powerful. I mean, this is ultimately, end of the day, we're talking about, you know, building your revenue and making sure that, you know, you're targeting those people and that you're hitting all of the right places to get those
and
installs.
Especially for those people for whom development is not a hobby, you know, it's their lifeblood.
Exactly.
You know, they make profit or they don't make a profit, depending on how well they market their applications, how well they build their applications, and how well they get them in the hands of consumers who can give you immediate feedback in Google Play as to whether that's working or not. And so I think the real sweet attention to detail and being able to help people promote it and get that right, I think we had incredible tools including translation. You know, how do you go ahead and translate your application? There's a way, even with integration with Google Wallet, it was really quick they did that demo. But you can go in and say, I need this application translated into Russian, or French, or whatever those ones that you need to knock out. And with a quick payment through Google Wallet, you go ahead and get that translated and shipped off through the Google Play Store.
Yeah.
And that really seemed like good attention to detail. You take and harness, as we said yesterday, you harness the data center of Google, you harness the internationalization and the real depth and scale that only Google can offer through Google Play, and bring it to developers so they can really make more money and have happier users.
Yeah, and including in the games space too. I mean, with the game services, you know, we talked to Greg and Duncan from the game side yesterday. I mean, what they're working on in the 30 launch partners that they have got right now, and the kinds of innovative games that they are working on with that community is amazing to me. I mean, it's the demos.
You know, 30 doesn't sound like a lot to us today.
Yeah, right.
But you look at the growth of Google. Every time I look at this I/O, you see the numbers go up. You know, you look at the 100 million to 400 million to 900 million Android. You've got to think, when you start to set the foundation and you do that right, you know, today we've got a sandbox of Google Plus partners, and we've got a sandbox full of games partners. What is that really going to look like next year? When you set the foundation and you build out the correct tools so developers can do a better job for users, and it's really incredible to think next year how many different people we're going to be talking to and how, what those numbers are going to look like.
Yeah, and you know, I want to just reference numbers a little bit because, you know, you and I yesterday talked to the cloud folks, and the numbers that they're talking about in terms of the latency and the
milliseconds.
Milliseconds, and then the storage capability that's possible today. Those numbers are heading in some amazing directions.
Right, you've got milliseconds down at the latency side, and you've got trillions and trillions of numbers that they're
being processed. Yeah, I mean, it's mind-blowing kind of stuff. Yeah,
right, and that's the type of thing. When you look at Google Scale, this isn't something that's very simple to replicate, and you have to really spend. I think Greg talked about it yesterday. They spent $2.6 billion on infrastructure. And that's a little bit of money.
Yeah.
And it's the right thing to do because it makes everybody's experience better. We talked about moving the bottleneck around. That's something that I've experienced. I have a long history in IT and working on network storage and things like that. And so you know you got to move that bottleneck around, be it the infrastructure and the computation to the network. And as Google continues to follow that and make sure the bottlenecks get out of the way so you can focus not only on your applications, but the user experience is really incredible. And I wanted to transition to something else. We had an opportunity yesterday to talk with Nicolas Garnier for Drive.
Mm-hmm.
Google Drive is 1 year old at Google I.O. this year. They've had incredible growth, incredible API development to work with developers so they can do real-time collaboration and a lot of really interesting things, and even use Drive as a hosted website platform. And you had an opportunity to go talk to the Drive Sandbox yesterday.
Yeah, that's right. They're part of our, they're in the Google Partner Apps area. And there are a couple of companies, and both of them, we talked to FedEx about what they're doing, and we talked to a group called HelloSign and HelloFax.
Mm-hmm.
In both cases, I felt like I really need to have both of these. I did not know about them ahead of time. And I think that the way that Drive is integrating with these types of, you know, in one case, a somewhat traditional company with FedEx and, you know, a relatively new company, and the way that they're thinking about how Drive can integrate with their services is fascinating.
And one thing, you mentioned HelloFax. You know, here we are in 2013, and we're bringing new ways to communicate still. And you
fax
take faxing.
Fax is not dead at all.
No, faxing is a very traditional business, traditional way of communicating. How do you take that into a connected web way? And so I'm looking forward to that. If we could go ahead and take a look at the Sandbox video from yesterday with Daniel talking to Drive.
Hi there, I'm Daniel Seberg with Google Developers Live here at I.O. 2013. We're at the Google Apps Partner Showcase, and I am talking right now with Joel from HelloFax and HelloSign,
and
we'll get into both of those. So tell me a little bit about what HelloFax is, first of all, and how it ties into Drive, because that's really what we're going to talk about.
Sure, so HelloFax turns Drive into a fax machine. It allows you to send and receive faxes as easy as it is to send and receive an email. So you don't have to worry about the whole printer, scanner, toner, all that stuff.
Is that fax sound, that dialing sound, is that optional?
We might do that as a plug-in later, but right now we don't have that.
Right. Okay, cool. So walk me through how this works within Drive.
Sure, and actually what I'll do is I'll show you HelloSign, because it's the same process. All you do is you upload a document, and then you can mark it up. So if you take a document here, let me see here, you get upload a document, and what you do is you edit and sign a document, and then you add in a fax number or you add in an email address. So what you do here is you see the markups of the document. Let me find one here. It allows you to add a signature. It allows you to add a checkbox. And what I'll do is I'll show you how to do a signature, because what happens, a lot of people, they need to sign a document. They need to get a contract signed, an invoice. You basically bring in your signature and you drop it in and you insert it there. You could draw that with a mouse, but I actually got to go with one that I've already uploaded in terms of an image file, so I'll use my saved one. And you insert that into a document, and then you can move that around.
So this is great. I mean, previously you would either have to print it out or scan it or something like that.
Exactly.
All of those things.
So everything is online and everything is within Drive. So you could turn around a contract or send out a fax in about 30 seconds, rather than driving to Kinko's or walking over to the printer and everything like that. So it's all self-contained and it's all Google integrated. We also have a great integration with Gmail. So you can actually see here, view, download, or sign. So you can sign a document in Gmail. Never need to leave Gmail. Never need to leave the services you like and to go ahead and do a sign a document.
And then you can see all of those documents within your Drive.
They show up automatically in your Drive. You have a sent and received folder. So all your important documents are where you care about them the most.
So tell me about the experience of working with the Drive team and, you know, HelloFax and HelloSign. working with those folks. How's that
been? Yeah, the Drives team has been awesome, and what we've really found is they've been really responsive to what we've been looking for and looking to do. And we actually have a new service coming out which allows you to upload documents directly from your mail and send them off the Drive, and it's really sort of seamless. So they've been really responsive, and we use Google Drive as a proxy for our service. In many cases, you don't even need to come to our site to do it.
This is fantastic. I have to sign up for HelloSign.
Please do.
And Halifax. All right, Joel, thank you so much.
Thanks a lot.
Appreciate it.
A lot of good content.
Yeah, sure.
And I have a G Plus post open.
The next partner that we're going to deliver to you is one that's no stranger to deliveries, and that is FedEx. But in this case, we're talking about FedEx Office and how that ties into Drive and documents and the ability to make these really cool presentations and then have them delivered to you. So joined right now by Lee from FedEx. So Lee, talk to me about how it integrates with Drive, how FedEx works with Drive.
Yeah, we've just recently introduced a new Google Drive app that basically allows you to port a wider range of file types directly from Google Drive directly into our print online interface, which is a really high-end designing type application that allows you to create finishing options for your documents, including binding, coils, covers, tabs, anything that you want to associate with creating physical print, we're able to do and transport your Google Drive file into that type of document.
And then it gets delivered to you, that final product gets delivered to you.
Yeah, you can actually choose to have it delivered to you, or you can actually have it chosen to be picked up in any of our 1,800 locations nationwide.
So walk me through what it looks like here.
So we have a variety of supported file types with our app, so it's just a matter of being within the Drive interface after you install the app and selecting those files and just right-clicking, selecting Open with FedEx Office. And essentially what that does is it launches up our print online application and it grabs those documents and ports it into that particular tool. I'm going to jump ahead a little bit and show you kind of what it looks like. So this is a file that we pulled in earlier, and it was a plain, basically, Google document that we're able to show right now as we're building it. You can almost see a soft proof of what it would look like to be produced and finished at FedEx Office. You can see with the coil binding, and we can change that to add binders, spines, a number of various options that people find useful when they're producing such documents.
And then folks can pay for all of this right here and select the option they want to get it?
Yeah, they can choose their closest FedEx Office location through the interface. And like you said, choose to ship it to their house if they don't even want to leave their couch. They can sit in their pajamas and do all this right from there.
So. Now, there's even a tie-in with mobile, too, as people want to access these documents and have a similar experience on a mobile device.
Exactly. So recently, we actually introduced our new FedEx Office mobile app. And our mobile app also ties into Google Drive, basically allowing you to directly grab a file from Google Drive within our mobile app and pretty much do exactly the same that's within our full-fledged e-commerce application, really offering customers a subset of those particular options, like if they want to create a flyer, a poster, presentation, give them some basic options that once again, through the app, they can pay for the finished product and have it shipped or picked up in any location.
And just quickly, how was the experience working with the Drive team from FedEx's standpoint?
Fantastic, really supportive. They were really there to answer any questions that we needed to. Just a really great experience overall.
Great, Lee, thank you so much. We appreciate it. And that's going to do it for the Google Apps Partner Showcase. I'm Daniel Seberg with Google Developers Live. Stay tuned for lots more content.